God, I love hearing this in one ear. Turn this over. Turn the monitor. Cool. Let's see this. So I get back down. I have cloud step. Have them all. Wait, nope. There's one item I don't have. Oh yeah, I have a thingy. Oh, not that. Not that. There we go. Pretty sure I missed. Oh, no, still got it. One. Yes. Oh. Come here so I don't have to do. I'm gonna die. Oh, no, let me hit you. Get the hell. Oh yeah, you come over here so I can hear my sensual voice. God damn it. Kill me. I deserve it. Walking, goddamn. Ugh, I can't even think of something witty. Gosh. Okay, so I didn't miss you. When I'm most in need of a messenger. There once was a land filled with bags. These bags were filled with evil monsters. Sleeping underwater during the day, they were kept at bay by the moon during nighttime. Well, when she was the kind enough to be around, after all, the moon was free to travel through space and often felt like shining her light on other realms. One day the moon got bored and decided to visit the bogland in human form. Wearing a cloak so that her light wouldn't shine through, she hoped to catch a glance of the evil creatures. Getting more than people wandering haphazardly in cursed lands usually bargain for, she encountered a man fleeing from a small pack of monsters. Confident in her power, she removed her cloak, creating a glittering aura of protection to help the man escape. Escape he did, but as he looked back, he saw that his savior had put her cloak back on a little too soon. She was captured by the creatures, who then buried her under rocks so her light would never shine again. They would rule the night. But her survivor was quick to gather a group of peasants, went to remove the big rock and set the moon free. A strong bond was formed that day. She decided to become their guardian. To this day, the moon is there to guide human travelers through the night. The end. Oh, you still need 1,000 for that. So you made it through the test of will. Oh, we are going to do the thing now? Oh, we're doing a fight? Yo, how you doing? Wow, what the hell is this thing? Okay, no, I don't hit that. No. Okay. God, I hate that thing. It's evil. Okay. It goes back, cool. Oh. Okay. And I'm dead. Oh, I'm gonna be hearing that sound a lot. Yep, totally input lag. actually have to be like there. Oh, he's trying to push me off. Okay, and then you. Okay. Get some balls. Not too fast. And I hit myself again. Oh shit. Yeah, actually got a free hit this time, cool. Probably get a couple of those, huh? This pattern again must not have gotten enough hits to finish this phase. Accidentally crossed over to the right side while I was pressing right. Thus, I am the dead. Okay. So did I accidentally actually figure out how to do the boss? Like, oh wait, there's this ability that I've been using this entire game. Maybe it would be useful now. Oh, I could just like jump, straight up jump on him? Okay. I kind of forgot that was next. Oh. Ah, crap. Crap. Didn't jump fast enough. At least I feel like I understand what I'm supposed to be doing a little bit more. No! No! Oh crap, I almost died there. Crap. I wasn't paying attention. What's the next phase, though? This one again? Really? Okay. Two times. That's not a lot. I pressed the wrong button. Eighty-three. They would say something like 52 the other time. Isn't inflating them? This one. Still? How many hits do I need to do? Just started and it's already getting. Maybe it would help if I started with full health. God damn it, Jeremy. Really? Maybe that's why you take so few hits. Because you aren't starting at full health. Still. Does it get wins? How many hits do I need to do to get to the next phase? Ah, shit. This is really where I'm getting hit. At that point, just take my life. That, like, can I really get hit by that? Mm-hmm. Okay. And to be honest, I almost died there. Oh, I like doing it from the other side. Ah, shit. Oh, that didn't even affect me. Cool. Is this the way the boss is meant to be, like, beaten? Oh, shit. Mods are prodded. Prodded. Join the KE Discord revolution today. What's the KE Discord? Oh, I'm on the outside. Oh, the Killian experience. Okay. That sounds familiar. I think I might have heard of that in the DE Discord. God. Not really part of the Dick Heater Discord, but it's been a second. Hey, killed it. So, what's special about the Killian Experience Discord? Think he's coming? Prophecy? So you made it through the test of might. Hey? Turkey started a revolution? Really? Revolution against what? Because to be honest, I am not the wisest about world matters. What the fuck is happening? Got a cool hat. Okay. The Parody mods. What are the Parody mods? Was that the Hero of the West over there? The default mods. Okay. So what the default mods do to deserve being, removed? Default is corrupt. Okay. Something sounds different. Seriously, something sounds. Everything sounds weird. But, like, so you're saying that default is corrupt. You're saying the very fact that they are the default mods is that they're correct? Not necessarily that, and not necessarily anything that they did? Island? Wait. It succeeded, and we got Ireland chat. So, Turkey started a revolution against the default mods, and there is Ireland chat. This sounds interesting. Album ruined. Oh, Ireland chat was deleted. Oh shit. You can't do that to Ireland. That's not fair. There needs to be an Ireland chat and a Scotland chat. They're their own separate thing. And so Turkey started the revolution and got Ireland deleted. Why not just delete every European country and just have the European Union, chat? Why not delete everything and have the, Earth chat? Oh, I'm in the future. Oh. There once was a starving little boy who never missed a chance to help his fellow villagers. One day, after helping an old man carry a bundle of wheat, he was offered a loaf of bread. "Eat your fill, my boy. It is well deserved," he began. "But if you feel like helping even more, there are two gnomes hiding in the forest who are even hungrier than you are." Now that boy was an empathetic one. His mind was made up instantly. After a short hike, he found the gnomes and split the bread between the two of them, without even saving a bite for himself. "Thank you, kind little boy," the gnomes beamed. "It seems you have lifted our curse." Indeed, to punish them for their greed, the spirit had put them under a rather annoying spell. They were exiled to the forest, carrying a magic little mill capable of producing anything its bearer desired. But the little mill's magic would only be activated once the gnomes were fed by a stranger, acting out of selfless generosity. Starved while carrying a relic promising abundance, a cruel fate indeed. Now you can imagine the little boy's surprise when he was given the magic item. Name something you want while turning the crank to the right, and the little mill will produce an endless stream of it, the gnomes explained. Turn it to the left and it will stop. After creating a huge pile of food for the two gnomes, the young boy went back to the village to help the populace with his newfound powers. But as he grew in popularity, his older sister grew in jealousy. One night, she couldn't take it anymore, stole the little mill from her brother's bedside table, along with two leftover pies from that afternoon's feast. Adding insult to injury, she left on the family's fishing boat to reach new lands, hoping to have her turn in the role of the popular purveyor. Once out at sea, she decided to try one of the pies, which to her taste were lacking a little something. It was time to try that little mill's magic, she reckoned. "Give me salt," she said, turning the crank to the right. and salt she got. Hopes, heaps and heaps of it. Now, older sister had neither bothered paying attention to how the mill could be stopped. Stop, little mill, stop, she shouted. First annoyed, then worried, then finally panicked. Salt soon overflowed the boat itself, sinking it to under the weight. It is said that the sunken little mill is still operational to this day. This is the reason why seawater is salty. Yes, bring us Earth chat. If we had Earth chat, we wouldn't have salty seas. Oh, she can only move to the right. Oh, default is a name of a person. I thought it meant like, oh, the regular default mod, not default the person. So, how do you plan on getting it back against this corrupt mod? That's part of why I was, I guess that was part of why I was so confused. I might be an idiot. Ireland will rise again. I respect that. Ireland needs to be free. Anyone who says otherwise is just
wrong.
Guy got a hat. I love this guy. Oh shit, I can go in clouds now? To be honest, I thought I was just gonna walk off. I'm dead. Why do they think I would, you know, be fine? Isn't it that the dragon, the dude from the future, was riding? Well, there was a dragon. Was that supposed to be hard or something? I can't get up there. So many spikes. Almost died there. God darn it. Guess I was going a little bit too fast. Need to hold forward there. Okay. That did not happen. Yes, you do. You love selfies. What am I trying to do? Just stand on the platform, jump off, and then be to the ladder.
Hey. I died. That'll probably keep happening. Oh, that zoomed me. And I died. Oh well, and I have to do that entire area again. My luck, I'll have 1,000 time shards by the end. I only have 543. Seriously, the theme in here sounds different. I almost died there. Oh, don't hold right, okay. So what will you do when Ireland rises again? You'll be there to witness it? Okay. Sounds like a grand thing to be a part of. I should have held off. I was way too far ahead of the camera. Oh, it's happened before. The prophet? Oh, the prophet wanted to repeat a lie. And on this day, the messenger shall unwittingly make his lifesaver indebted to him. And that means? So this is Ireland's third coming. Okay. Oh, can probably. as she was going. I need to strategically choose where I stand so I know where, you know, I'll actually have land to stand on. Yo, 5 damage? Slowly figuring out this. What the fuck? What the hell? What the? What the fuck? What? Just destroy the entire thing. No warning. I got really close. I got to third phase. They're telling me I would have had that damage reduction by now if I didn't die so many times. Thanks for letting me know that. Okay, thanks for coming by, man. It's nice talking to you. Let me know about the liberation of Ireland in the future. That was such a good start too. Like five hits. Damn. Really? By jumping, I was in the air, you idiot. That was a little frustrating. Wait, why don't I just hover and hit them? Kinda like I forgot I could do that. That helped me stay in the air a little bit better. Ah, it's like a free hit. Two free hits. Three. That was frustrating. Really? First fucking phase? First fucking phase and it does that. I was holding down jump. Wow, Jeremy, wow. Is there any way to kill that thing before it gets to that phase? Because that just feels bullshit. Oh wow, okay. No. So even after that bullshit phase, I'm not done. I have to do that shit again? I have to go through that shit again. That shit again. 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 God fucking damn. That's frustrating. And at that point, it doesn't really matter how much damage I take earlier on. Really, that's not enough damage for you? Time for the dive. Fucking finally.
Ugh. Hugs me now?
I've been watching you for my messenger.
Even now I can lounge again.
I was in kind of
all air.
Who are you anyway?
This guy's dead for you. It's a shame you freed my slave pet, but no matter. I'm now certain I can defeat
you.
I prepared adventure.
Oh, I'm going to the underworld.
Okay.
Welcome to the Lion's Den.
Come on, I'm happy to avoid certain cliches, but I think we wouldn't have a lava to end up in your to end your epic quest is pushing it.
There once was a guy visited by a succubus. Far from being that kind of demon, she offered him a unique chance to visit hell as a tourist. Very adventurous by nature, jumped right into the portal. He arrived in a room where giant cauldrons boiled over bonfires that contained people, the little demons with pikes sitting on the rim to push anyone who tried to escape back inside. Who's in that cauldron? The man asked the succubus tour guide. This one? This is where the liars and cheaters end up, she explained. And this one over there, she continued, that's for people who hunt for sport. Gassed, the man noticed another cauldron, much bigger than the other ones, and devoid of any demons sitting on its rim. Indeed, that one cauldron seemed to self-regulate. People were pulling back anyone who tried to escape. And who's this cauldron for? He asked, curious as to be stubborn in their ideology. They would rather hurt themselves than rethink their worldview. Oh, that cauldron? The succubus mused. That's for people who think the order doesn't apply anymore when another line opens up at the market.
What? Are those... Okay. Okay. I have been visiting him. And all he has left is that $1,000 upgrade. All health. Got it. Shut up. You're really getting it.
Mm-hmm. second too early. Entire level, two levels of not buying shit, and they still don't have 1,000. Human general. Another one that I really have to, I guess I have to find. How do you fucking avoid that?
did I get hit by? Those other times. Did I not get hit by him because I was using my rope chain? Is that why? Did that give me invincibility frames? That was so much easier than the dragon. Ah, Rouse. Why am I not surprised? I tried. The dragon saved me. Oh, it talked. Manfred.
Okay. So I'm the hero of the West.
Okay.
Soldier. Yo, this is Wow. Okay. And so your time as the messenger is up. What do I do now? Yay. What? Yo, you get to open the cabinet. All right, let me share with you my understanding of Madame Melody's work. After observing so many humans over such a long period of time and reading as much as I could, some trends inevitably come up. One thing we all have in common is the need to feel like we have value, power, and abundance in our lives. Now, like many things, there are functional and dysfunctional ways to go about these. Say you are dysfunctional. Your sense of value may come from the approval of others, making you dependent on seeking attention, begging for others to tell you that who you are is adequate. You will feel good when you receive positive feedback, but always be one negative comment away from having your day ruined. Now, about power. Dysfunctional people can get a sense of power by exercising control over others, sometimes right down to policing the way they talk or who they engage with. They feel good when they have a weak partner control, or feel depressed and weak themselves when no one is around to feed their ego. Their sense of abundance will often come from material things, displaying of high status, or promiscuity. Even though it feels great while the money and the crowd are there, these lack real depth. The impact of the inevitable downfall would be hard to overstate. For functional people, it is scarcely documented as they are generally busy living a meaningful life. Functional people get their sense of value from an understanding and acknowledgement of their inner worth. Their sense of power comes from an ability to self-contain and let others be who they are while protecting themselves when needed. Abundance simply comes from a good self-care. Now, all of this makes sense in theory, but the idea is to be able to apply it. For this, you first need to master your emotions. As I understand it, everything you experience is a mix of the big five: fear, joy, sadness, anger, and shame, the primary colors of our experiences. Mixed fear with anger, you get jealousy. Too much sadness in your joy will make you melancholic. The only way to unpack complex emotions is by breaking them down into which of the big five are concerned, to deal with each of these individually. Easier said than done, right? Consider haunted house stories for a mutant. They're always the same, aren't they? Starts off with optimistic fools moving in. Soon enough, odd things begin to happen, and fear ensues for a while. Eventually, the protagonist has had enough, decides to face the ghost. "What? What do you want?" they will ask, tired of cowering in fear. As it turns out, ghosts usually know what they want. And it's usually the same thing for the person who wronged them to face justice, then to be put to rest. That's usually where the killer faces a trial, the ghost's body is respectfully buried. Just like that, the house becomes a warm haven again. Did you get the metaphors? You often feel depressed, irritated, or however hindered with your general ability to engage with life. You're just like a haunted house. Your inner child is hurt and will be increasingly uncomfortable to you. Then you turn around and ask, what? What do you want? If asked honestly, you will find that answers were within you all along, and that following through with the inner child's requests is both challenging and life-changing. Only then can you begin the process of discovering your true self, to finally get rid of your chain. These were my final ramblings. Please keep in mind that I am but a shopkeeper. Everything I say should be taken with the biggest grain of salt you can. Please open the cabinet now. Wait. No. God damn. Raytroid. Oh. Oh, shit. Did I kill the messenger? Then okay, came back. What? This isn't over? What? A born-again messenger will master time itself and the curse by fighting in two cycles simultaneously. What? Wait, what? What's going on?
So the messenger
and so the messenger rises once more. I really missed the time when we did this. Oh, the store looks different. I guess that's because we're in the Tower of Time. I have a map? Oh, that's hilarious. What? Oh my god, I'm in love. So this ninja guy game actually turns out to be a Metroidvania. Oh my gosh. I'm seriously in love. Not anymore.
What? Holy crap. Did I say I'm in love? Because I'm in love. More upgrades. I still want that. I'll be back. I guess I'm back. Wait, where am I?
Wait, so I can go to this area in the past? Oh shit. I remember having to climb up that. This is a good feeling. The music changes. I definitely remember getting up here.
Oh.
Oh. So that was meant to be a surprise, like, oh shit. Taking too many hits, okay. This just makes me want to see a speed, 100% speed run of this game before I even finish it. Really? That was not intentional.
Oh, all the way back here. And with that, I'm done for the day. Been playing for about 3 hours. I'm good. So, thanks for coming out. Hope you enjoyed the stream. If you aren't following, follow. And please, I hope you visit the Trampoline Empire again. Have a good night. Bye.